According to me, I think our bowling attack has been up there with the best, if not the best bowling attack in the competition. I think the way we have bowled in low scoring games, even coming back into the match when the guys have been hit, I think we have shown a lot of character. And New Zealand attack has always been a very balanced bowling attack. Their pacers are very consistent. Mitchell Santner brings in a lot of control with his skills in the middle overs. So, yeah, they're a team which has always been a very consistent team. So we know that up against them, we'll have to be very, very disciplined. At the same time, we'll have to play very correct cricket to, you know, score runs against them because they bowl in good lines and lengths. And it's going to be a nice battle. We've played against them a lot. But yeah, they're a quality side and a very, very potent bowling attack. It's great that, you know, Rohit is scoring so consistently, which means that coming in the later in half of the innings, you have to play a different role, which is controlling the middle overs and letting guys like Hardik and, you know, Kedar and MS in the past few games and now Rishabh come out and express themselves. I think playing a team sport, you need to be able to adapt. And I'm very, very happy doing that role. And I hope he gets two more so that, you know, we can win two more games because it's an outstanding achievement. It's not even 2008. I remember 2007, we went to New Zealand and we're playing, you know, an under-19 test match and he played a shot off one of our fast bowlers who was quick off the back foot. And I remember standing in slips and just telling guys standing at slip, I've never seen anyone play a shot like that. And he was special along with a couple of more guys which didn't make it, surprisingly. But he was always the standout player. And you could see even when we played New Zealand in New Zealand on that under-19 tour. And then, yes, the World Cup again, he was quite special for them. So we always knew he has the special ability to go all the way. And now he's, you know, controlling the tempo of the game for New Zealand every game that he plays. And he's contributing so well. And he's a lovely guy. We get along very well. So, yeah, he's always been, you know, the main guy for them along with Ross, who have performed really consistently. So I think those two guys have shared the load so far. And a lot will depend on them, obviously, because they've been playing well. And according to us, from our team point of view, getting both of them early will be crucial. Well, it comes back to the same point, handling pressure. You know, you make two bad decisions while you're chasing and the game goes away from you, too far away to pull it back. So I assume that that's going to be the case because, you know, having been in so many chases, I understand that the pressure can be very high if you don't go with the pace of the game. And then understanding the magnitude of a tournament like this, you're probably going to end up making a couple of mistakes and the opposition's not going to let you off after that. So, yeah, look, we're not worried about the toss. It's an uncontrollable. You can't really predict what's going to happen at the toss. We have to be prepared both ways and we're quite open to do that. And if it is a factor, it is a factor.